What we should actually be asking ourselves as a house that makes laws, how do we sit down and regulate this radicalization or regulate these religious groups that are cropping up? And I think that is more important, because what has happened has already happened. We already see reaction by the government. We've seen the police there. We've seen today the Minister of Interior there. We've seen so many rescue missions happening there. We've seen people being taken, of course, for rescue centers and such. That is now what under the bridge. What we should be discussing in this house is what we should do to regulate these religious cults that are happening. And for me, Honorable Speaker, I get surprised all over, because this thing has happened, is actually happening all over. When people choose to believe human beings, the good book in the book of John chapter 10 verse 10 promises life and life in abundance. You do not need a broker to get to Christ. You do not need any person to stand by your way when you're going to Christ as Christians. And I do not understand at times that people have chosen, even the learned ones, have chosen to go, you know, to be radicalized by people, and some who are actually not learned, calling themselves serious titles, doctors, so and so, how they acquired those doctorates, I mean, really cannot be explainable. And for us, Honorable Speaker, for this house, it is about time we come up with measures. We have the responsibility to regulate these churches. We have the responsibility to come up with law. If it means coming up with a particular ministry or proposing some particular act of parliament, particularly for these churches or religious groups, then so be it. We can go the Rwanda way, where you can't just wake up one morning and open a church and change your voice and twist your voice and speak as though you've been preaching the entire night and start saying, I spoke to God last night, I spoke to him this morning, I spoke to him over lunchtime, and then make people give you money. It was actually very sad to read a story of a lady, a air hostess, that decided to dispose of her property at a meager amount of about 7 million. I hear the property is worth 50 million. And she took that money to the pastor who is not fasting. And then she went to the forest to fast inside the forest where the pastor is eating. And worse, I hear that these people had even the supervisors and people taking, you know, moving around to see whether they are fasting, monitors moving around, whip, they are whipping them to see whether they are fasting. It is actually wrong. It is wrong. And for us, as the government is doing, you know, much in regard to recovery of the bodies and such, the house needs to sit down and come up with measures to regulate that. But even as I finish, Honorable Speaker, the world should know that there is nothing wrong in owning anything on earth. In the book of Psalms 24:1, Honorable Speaker, the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, the world and what dwells therein belongs to God. So the imaginary thing of some people telling them, sell your things, that these things belong to the earth, even that earth belongs to God.